NASA's James Webb Space Telescope has only been in operation for a year, but it has already impressed scientists with its discoveries and stunning images of planets, stars, and exoplanets from deep space. In the most recent development, astronomers using NASA's JWST to capture the first ever direct image of a planet outside our solar system. Because it is mostly made of gas and lacks a rocky surface, the discovered planet is unlikely to be habitable. How did the JWST get such a sharp focus on a planet so far away? Why are NASA's findings about Jupiter so exciting? Let's dive in and know more. Hey guys, welcome back to the Future Space. In today's video, we are going to talk about the James Webb Telescope, which discovered a massive structure on Jupiter. Without any further ado, let's get started. This NASA image depicts a false color composite image of Jupiter captured by the JWST on July 27, 2022. The planet's rings and some of its minor satellites can be seen, as well as background galaxies. The world's newest and largest space telescope has captured images of Jupiter never seen before, complete with auroras. Scientists released images of the solar system's largest planet. The images were captured by the JWST in July, providing unprecedented views of Jupiter's northern and southern lights, as well as swirling polar haze. The Great Red Spot of Jupiter, a storm large enough to swallow Earth, stands out brightly among countless smaller storms. "We've never seen Jupiter quite like this before. It's all quite incredible," said Imke de Pater of the University of California, Berkeley, who assisted in the observations. According to the U.S.-French research team, the infrared images were artificially colored in blue, white, green, yellow, and orange to highlight the features. The $10 billion successor to the Hubble Space Telescope rocketed away at the end of last year and has been observing the cosmos in the infrared since summer. Scientists hope to see the dawn of the universe with Webb, peering all the way back to when the first stars and galaxies formed 13.7 billion years ago. JWST has already captured images of galaxies so far away from Earth that cosmic expansion has shifted their light well into the infrared region of the spectrum, which the telescope is designed to detect, and the observatory's near-infrared spectrograph has discovered carbon dioxide in the atmosphere of exoplanet WASP-39b, the first definitive detection of this gas in a planet beyond our solar system. But JWST has also set its sights closer to home. On July 27, astronomers used the telescope's powerful infrared eyes to target Jupiter, revealing images that are both familiar and exotic. Jupiter's NIRCam captured two images of our solar system's largest planet. In the striking close-up directly, taken through three different filters, Jupiter displays numerous cloud bands, as well as storms and auroral emissions. The equatorial zone spans the planet's girth and appears bright white because its high-altitude hazes reflect lots of sunlight. Meanwhile, the cyan hues reveal clouds buried deeper in Jupiter's atmosphere, showing light reflected from the planet's main cloud level at a pressure of about 1 bar, roughly the atmospheric pressure at Earth's surface, as well as the transition between the banded structures seen at equatorial and mid-latitude regions that Earthbound observers are familiar with, as well as more complex vortices at higher latitudes. Japan's massive auroral ovals appear as reddish glows near the giant's north and south poles, caused by ionized hydrogen atoms that extend up to 625 miles above the cloud tops. The greenish areas around the poles are caused by hazes in the planet's atmosphere that are 60 to 120 miles high, and you can trace this haze layer down to equatorial latitudes. The spectacular wide-field view of Jupiter combines images through two infrared filters. The Jovian clouds and aurorae remain visible, but many more details appear in this composite. The power of JWST is exemplified by its ability to capture Jupiter's faint and dusty rings in the same image as the bright planet itself, which shines 1 million times brighter than the rings. A rich background of scattered light pervades, with the most obvious sources being diffraction spikes from Jupiter's aurorae and the bright moon that intersects the two visible moons. Diffraction spikes occur in reflecting telescopes like Webb when light interacts with the struts that support its secondary mirror. Because our vision does not pick up infrared radiation, the colors in these images do not match what the human eye would see when observing Jupiter. However, the image processors for these stunning shots, citizen scientists Judy Schmidt and Ricardo Huzo of the University of the Basque Country in Spain, mapped longer infrared wavelengths to the red end of the visible spectrum and shorter wavelengths towards the blue, mimicking how the human eye perceives visible light. Images are only one aspect of JWST's observing prowess. The telescope's spectroscopic capabilities are also being applied to Jupiter. On July 27, astronomers took near-infrared spectra of the Great Red Spot and similar observations in the mid-infrared on August 14 and 15. Jupiter's aurorae, on the other hand, will be subjected to closer spectroscopic scrutiny later this year. JWST scientists have high hopes for what the next-generation space telescope can teach them about the Jupiter system. Astronomers hope to better understand the structure of Jupiter's ring system, providing insight into where it originated and how it will evolve. Finally, planetary scientists hope to create maps of the surface and atmosphere of both the volcanic and icy moons. This artistic interpretation of an image from NASA's Juno mission that shows the planet's famous Great Red Spot brings Jupiter's already vibrant colors to a whole new level of intensity. A piece that Mary J. Murphy, a citizen scientist, calls The Rose, was created through the processing of an image taken by the JunoCam instrument aboard the spacecraft by increasing the amount of color saturation. Will this red spot will swallow the Earth? What do you think? Please let us know in the comments down below. The Great Red Spot is a storm that is located in the southern hemisphere of Jupiter. It has clouds that are a crimson color and rotate in a counterclockwise direction at wind speeds that are much faster than any storm on Earth. The Great Red Spot has undergone gradual transformations over the course of many years, and its current width is approximately 1.3 times that of our planet. Scientists were able to determine, with the assistance of data that was returned by the Juno mission, that the roots of the storm extend at least 200 miles into Jupiter's atmosphere. To put this in perspective, the average tropical cyclone that forms on Earth is only about 9 miles long, from the eye of the storm to the center of the storm. A scientist at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Southern California named Marcia Parisi says in a press conference, "Despite the wealth of information that we have about the winds that are surrounding the Great Red Spot and the dynamic that is surrounding the Great Red Spot, we knew very little about the depth of the Great Red Spot," said the researcher. According to Parisi, who was part of a Juno mission that used gravity measurements to investigate this and some of Jupiter's other storms, the question of the spot's depth has puzzled scientists for decades, with many believing that the storm is only skin deep at the surface of Jupiter. The original image captured by JunoCam was captured on July 20, 2019 at 9:37 p.m. during the 21st close flyby of Jupiter that the Juno spacecraft was performing. The spacecraft was approximately 27,000 miles away from the planet's cloud tops when the image was captured, and it was located at a latitude that was approximately 47 degrees south. For all that science can tell us, Jupiter still has plenty of secrets to uncover, and that's what keeps it on the edge of its seat. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed the video. If so, please click on the like button and share it with your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments, please share them with us in the comment space below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more of our incredible videos. You can also check out our other videos that have been specially selected for you. We'll catch up in the next video.